The referee is from South Africa, Stan Christodoulou, who is refereeing a Pedroza world title fight for the fifth time. McGuigan's face is ripped by the attention of Pedroza's left jab. Pedroza very alert, his mind's on the job, and he knows he doesn't have an easy challenge here. And McGuigan smashes through the first good punches of the fight. Two punches, left and right, but he has to take a right under the heart. Never keep this pace up. What a wonderful start to a fight, and McGuigan catches him again. The speed of punch. He's beating Pedroza to it. Pedroza lets one go slightly low, and he rips a right uppercut inside, a good one. And they hardly heard the bell. They were so hard at it. Some fight. Good right from Pedroza as McGuigan moved inside. McGuigan roughing him up inside, leaning on him, takes an uppercut, and once again they don't hear the bell. Pedroza must have covered half a mile already in this big ring. Round and round he goes, circling all the time. Caught by the right, he wasn't quick enough to get away. He's like an Irish terrier. And you wait here and wonder who's going to do the first real damage, who's going to be really hurt first. And somebody is sure to be soon. Clubbing left hooks on the head of Pedroza. He shakes him off. Good left from Pedroza. McGuigan ignores it and goes in again. McGuigan hurts him again. Heaven knows who's going to weaken first. Pedroza shrugs his shoulders as though he's seen it all before. Good punches from Pedroza, picked him off. Pedroza beginning to bring the right hand into it more and more. Hard punches being exchanged in this fifth round. Very hard. McGuigan finding his opponent with everything, and still Pedroza's there and still coming back at him. And again they fight after the bell. That's three times in a row. This is a tremendous fight. He took one back. McGuigan comes strongly again towards the end of this sixth round. It's surpassing all expectations in the brilliance of it. And this time, Mr. Christodoulou steps between them. McGuigan's work has not been so effective in this round. He hasn't found the range. champions over in this event. He found him with the right. Compulsory £8. Is the title about to change hands? 30 seconds to go. Can McGuigan do it here and now? We thought he'd find him with the left hook and he found him with the right. Seconds left in this round. There's the bell. They don't hear it, and I'm not surprised. Pedroza on the floor from the right hand in the seventh round, and I can hardly, as I self speak to you, under the inferno of sound. What a beautiful right hand this was. He was going away to the ropes. Oh, never saw it coming. McGuigan had better be careful, because this man is at his most dangerous when he's hurt. And he's finding McGuigan with good punches again. Good punches. Doubt that McGuigan was a good challenger, and certainly there's no doubt now. And he found him with the right again, in the same place on the ropes. Blistering assault by McGuigan. Wonderful. Oh, good right again, and once again it's in the same spot in the ring, the self same place where he put him down.
Pedroza's in,
and Pedroza is on very, very rocky legs. Our place is going berserk with excitement. Round 10, and McGuigan's on the verge of winning the World Featherweight Championship. Pedroza's still there. In come the punches again. As Pedroza weakens towards the end of the round. This is an important moment in this fight, because now McGuigan is going further in a professional fight than he's ever been. He's never been beyond 10 rounds. One more slip could be his last. The punches from Pedroza coming back. Amazing champion. Round and round this ring, Pedroza goes, trying to keep out of trouble. McGuigan's found him again with the left hook. And it was always when Pedroza was backing up to the ropes. Pedroza finding new strength again. How does he do it? Came with a good right then, Pedroza. Pedroza's hurt. And a left and another left, and he's going. He's going, the legs have gone. It's the 30th round, and Pedroza's on the verge of defeat again. Is this to be the round? Is this to be the lucky 30th for McGuigan? He's got him reeling. One more good punch would do it, surely. Pedroza hangs inside. No respite for him. What a great champion he is. Look at him up there trying to survive. 5 seconds to go. The bell is going to come to his aid again. There it is. And once again, Pedroza goes to his corner. Saved. Hurting him again, and when Pedroza's mouth comes open, you can see the blood on the gum shield. Then the right hand. ...25,000 people singing McGuigan home to victory. Pedroza pumps his arms. He tries to find something with which to stop this little dynamo, the Clona's cyclone coming at him, and he can't. I've never heard such excitement in my life as this crowd is creating here. McGuigan going for the win. He's got him with the right hand again. 10 seconds, and Pedroza is going to survive. What a marvellous champion. He takes two rights at the end, and that surely must be the end of Pedroza's reign as champion. Everybody in the place is acclaiming McGuigan the victor, but to make it official, we have to wait for the official score, that McGuigan is hoisted on his hands and shoulders.
The result, a unanimous decision by McGuigan.
McGuigan has won it. McGuigan is the champion of the world. They've all voted for him, and all 25,000 people in the stadium had already voted for him. At 24, the Clona's cyclone has swept one of the world's great champions out of the way.